Human rights defenders can be described as people who promote and protect human rights peacefully. Promoting and protecting human rights is something most staff at national human rights institutions will recognize from the Paris Principles that outline the mandate of national human rights institutions. Staff at national human rights institutions can be considered human rights defenders, but there are also a lot of other human rights defenders in the world. No matter who they are and where they work, the chances are that their work to promote and protect human rights has become harder due to the political climate. Reports from different organizations show a slide towards a shrinking democratic or civic space, including the narrowing of human rights and freedoms. For example, a Global Civic Space rating from 2021 shows that today nearly 70% of the world's population live in countries with repressed or closed civic space. One of the big groups of human rights defenders affected by this is women. In a report from 2019, the UN Special Rapporteur on Human Rights Defenders wrote, "In the current political climate in which there is a backlash against human rights, women defenders are often the first to come under attack. Women human rights defenders are people working to promote women's rights or women and girls working to promote and protect human rights within all aspects of public life. An example of women human rights defenders are people fighting for equal pay, whether they be women, men, or non-binary. The gender pay gap, which means that women are paid less to do the same work as men, still exists in almost every country in the world and has been documented by numerous reports and statistics. Another example is women human rights defenders fighting for land and property rights. For instance, the women living in rural areas and indigenous women who go against land grabbing, lack of access to clean water and extraction industries. And more generally, the inequality in terms of property and land ownership. Women often experience a gap between law and actual practice when it comes to land assets. An OECD analysis showed that in 29% of the 180 countries studied, women and men have equal rights to own, use, and control land in law and practice. The most discussed examples of women human rights defenders are probably those fighting for women's sexual and reproductive health and rights. Human rights defenders can, for example, take the shape of women talking publicly about sexual and reproductive health, including abortion, LGBT+ persons fighting for equality, and women speaking up about sexual harassment. According to UN Special Rapporteur on Human Rights Defenders, women or LGBT+ persons defending sexual and reproductive health and rights may be perceived as challenging religious and cultural norms, triggering a backlash. The backlash can appear in many different ways. In a survey from 2013, 51% of women human rights defenders working with sexual and reproductive rights had at some point received violent messages, threats, or offensive comments while working online. Many are also seen as sexually promiscuous in their defense on women's sexual rights. While women human rights defenders face the same risks and restrictions as other human rights defenders, they also have to deal with additional risks and obstacles that are related to their gender and ideas and norms about how women should be. The gendered risks that women human rights defenders might face take a wide range of forms, all aimed at deterring their work, from threats to their livelihoods, family or children, to sexual harassment and rape. Sexual violence aims at physical and psychological harm and at isolating the defenders from their community. The attacks can be carried out by police or military personnel, and sometimes by their family or community. For example, numbers from Central America and Mexico have shown that 54% of the attacks made against women human rights defenders are by police, military personnel, public officials, or authorities at different levels of government. Women human rights defenders might also be perceived as a dishonor for the entire family, and gender roles can become a barrier for the women's work in public spaces. In certain cultures, religions, and populations, women's engagement in public life is seen as a family matter, not a political matter. So as a response to their work, they might be branded as negligent mothers, bad wives, or mentally unstable. Women human rights defenders face isolation from their support network and separation from their children or even forced psychiatric treatments. These risks and obstacles combined can potentially hinder women in promoting and protecting human rights. And because women human rights defenders are often not acknowledged as human rights defenders, but as a family problem and thus silenced, they have much less visibility and credibility in wider society than their male counterparts. As a result, their struggles are generally underreported, even though the stakes are high. At the International Conference of GANRI in 2018, the participating national human rights institutions presented the Marrakesh Declaration on Human Rights Defenders with a special focus on women human rights defenders. National human rights institutions signing the declaration commit to a range of actions to promote and protect human rights defenders. These actions include promote gender equality and combat all forms of discrimination of women human rights defenders. Support the development and strengthening of national and regional women human rights defenders networks. Support capacity development with particular focus on women human rights defenders. To learn more about women human rights defenders and what you can do, visit ganri.org. Women human rights defenders work is human rights work, and recognizing women human rights defenders is a key component in their protection.